To make white chocolate panna cotta, we will need 300 grams of cream, 150 grams of milk, 50 grams of sugar, 60 grams of white chocolate, 15 coffee beans, and 6 grams of gelatin. First, we will want to melt our chocolate using a bain-marie or water bath method, in which the steam of the water heating our bowl melts the chocolate, which will prevent the chocolate from burning. Leave the chocolate to melt on a low heat. Once we have that going, we can leave it aside and get our panna cotta mixture going. Put your cream, milk, sugar, and coffee beans in the saucepan. Now you want to crush your beans in half before you drop them in the saucepan. Bring the mixture to the boil, and once it's boiling, take it off the heat and cover the saucepan with a cling film and leave it for at least 5 minutes to let the mixture infuse some of the coffee flavor. This way we'll introduce some earthy flavors to balance out the sweetness of the dessert. After 5 minutes, your chocolate should be melted and ready to be mixed with the panna cotta mixture. Use a sieve or chinois to put your mixture through because we want to take all of the coffee bits out. Once that's done, get your panna cotta back into a clean saucepan and bring it to simmer. While our mixture is heating up, get a bowl of cold tap water and soak your gelatin in the water. It won't take long till your gelatin is softened up, and once it has, take it out and squeeze the water out of it and put it into your panna cotta mixture, which at this point should be simmering. Leave the mixture to simmer for around a minute or two and whisk it to make sure your gelatin is completely melted and incorporated into the panna cotta mixture. Once that's done, take your saucepan off the heat and put the mixture through a sieve or chinois again to make sure we don't have any leftover bits going into our final stage of the dessert. I'm going to portion this panna cotta into 4 molds, of which each of them will have around 110 grams of mixture. Once it's portioned, cling film your panna cotta and put it in the fridge. It's best to leave it overnight, if not, I recommend giving it around 6 hours to set. At this point, we want to make our own summer berry jam. I will be using 400 grams of frozen summer berries, and we will also need 100 grams of sugar. Put your saucepan on a medium heat, put all of your ingredients in the saucepan and mix it. It might seem dry at the beginning, but it won't take long until the juices of the berries starts to come out. You want to bring your berries to the boil and leave them to simmer for about 10 to 15 minutes. You should also note that the more you reduce, the thicker your jam will become. Once 15 minutes has passed, most of the berries will be broken apart, and if you still have some whole berries left, try and break them apart. Take the pan off the heat and leave your jam to cool down. For the last part, once your panna cotta has set, take the cling film off and put the mold under a warm tap water like so. This way your panna cotta will slightly melt on the sides, which will allow us to take it out. Don't overdo it. You want to tap slightly on the side or shake it to see if your panna cotta is moving inside the mold. If it is, get your plate ready and take it out like so. Put your homemade jam on top and enjoy your white chocolate panna cotta. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't hesitate to like and subscribe.